turn back to me. How many's bound for that city tonight? Yeah. Isn't it gonna be wonderful when we get there? I believe there's getting ready to be a meeting, don't you? Are you ready for that meeting in the air? Glory, there's gonna be a meeting.
And Jonah and the whale, we often sing. Well, there are many, many others in the Bible. Well, I should like to meet them, I do declare. By and by, the Lord has surely led us. Meet him by the meeting in the air. Well, there's
going to be a meeting there
in that sweet, sweet by and by.
Oh, I'm going to meet you, meet you there.
In that
home beyond the sky, yeah.
Singing you were here, never heard my mortal ear. We'll be glorious,
I do declare. God's own son will be leading one at that meeting in the air.
Well, you have heard a little Moses and Moses. You have heard a little David and his sling. Well, you have heard the stories of Dream and Joseph. And the Jonah and the whale, we often. Well, there are many, many others in the Bible. But I should like to meet them all, I do declare. By and by, the Lord will surely let us meet them by that meeting in the air. Well, there's
going to be a meeting.
Aren't you ready for the meeting in the air?
Whoa.
I am going to meet you, meet your man. In that hope beyond the sky. Oh, they're singing you will hear. Never heard my mortal ear. Will be glorious,
I do declare.
God's own son will be the one at that meeting in the air.
There is going to
be a meeting there.
In that sweet, sweet
by
I'm going to meet you, meet all them. In that home
beyond the sky,
singing you hear, that heard my mortal ear, to be glorious, I do declare.
And God's own son will be leading one at that meeting.
Aren't you excited about the meeting in the air?
There's going to be
a meeting in the air, in that sweet, sweet fire.
Yes, there is, Lord.
To meet you, meet your man in that home beyond the sky.
That singing you will hear,
that heard my mortal ear, will be glorious,
I do declare.
And God's own son will be leading one at that meeting.
Aren't you ready for your meeting? Come on.
Going to our meeting there in that sweet, sweet land by
in that home beyond the sky.
Come on, church, aren't you excited tonight? We're in heaven, we can get excited.
Glorious, yeah. I do declare. And God's own son will be leading one at the meeting in the air.
There is going to be a meeting in the air.
And that sweet, sweet fire.
There,
in that home
beyond the sky,
so I sing to you will hear. Then heard my mortal ear will be glorious,
I do declare.
And God's own son will be leading one at that meeting in the air.
There is going
to be a meeting in the
air. There's going to be a meeting in the church, in the sweet, sweet by and by.
There's going to be. hold them in that hall beyond the sky. Well, I'll sing a new hymn that hurt my mortal ear. We'll be glorious, I believe there. And God's own son will be leading one at that meeting in the air. And so we will be in the air. In that sweet, sweet,
yes,
forever.
Are you ready for your meeting? Well, that's gonna be a
meeting. That sweet, sweet by and by. Heard my mortal ear will be glorious. I do declare. Yeah, God's own son will be leading one at that meeting in the air. Well, there is going to be a meeting in the air. In that sweet, sweet fine line,
I'm
going to meet you. Meet you all there in that home beyond the sky. And you will hear that heard my mortal ear will be glorious, I do declare. And God's own son will be leading.
Yes, he will. Whoa, that's a meeting in the air.
It's going to be a meeting in the air.
Yes, come on, church, let's praise him tonight. There's going to be a meeting.
Whoa. To meet you, meet you over there in that home beyond the sky. Home.
Yeah. Hallelujah. Aren't you ready for that meeting in the air?
Whoa. I do declare. And God's own son will be leading one at that meeting.
One more time, there's gonna be a meeting.
There's gonna be a meeting.
Aren't you looking forward to it? Yes, we are.
To meet you over there in that home beyond the sky. Well, I'm singing you here. They've heard my mortal ear. We'll be glorious, I do declare. And God's own son will be leading one at that meeting in the air. And God's own son will be leading one at that meeting in the air.
Yeah. Glory, glory, glory. Praise God. There's going to be homecoming. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. You know I'm so looking forward to. How many's got somebody at that meeting in the air that you're looking forward to meeting? Praise God. How many believes there's going to be a homecoming? How many's looking forward to your homecoming? Gonna get to see mamas and daddies and brothers and sisters. And gonna get to see all the secrets that heaven ever holds. But you know, above all that, above everything that we're gonna see, what I look forward to seeing more than anything is I'm gonna get to see my Jesus, King Jesus, face to face. Gonna get to see him, amen, the one that walked up an old rugged, old hill called Mount Calvary and died for our sins. I'm looking forward to our homecoming, brother. I'm looking forward to our homecoming. We're going to have a homecoming that gets you excited, don't it? Hallelujah. Just to think when we get here and we get in revival, when we get revived, what it feels like. Can't you just imagine what it's going to be like when we get to heaven and we get in the homecoming and get to celebrate throughout all eternity? Amen? We're going to have a homecoming. Praise God.
Hello.
Hello, sis. It's good to hear your voice again. I haven't seen or heard from you since I don't know when. Thank you, Jesus. When God called Mom away, our whole family went astray. We have to pull together now for our homecoming day.
I know, brother, time is drawing near. We may not see each other again till we meet up there. God's soon gonna call us away and praise His name.
We're gonna
have a homecoming. We're gonna walk streets of gold. We're gonna sing with the angels. See all the secrets heaven holds. We're gonna get to see Mama and hold Jesus' hand. Oh, what a great homecoming when we're together again.
Yeah. We're gonna have a homecoming.
Have a homecoming.
We're gonna walk streets of gold.
Yes, we are gold.
We're gonna sing with the angels. The secret heaven,
gonna see every secret.
We're gonna get to see Mama,
yes,
and hold Jesus' hand.
Yes, we are. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, what a great homecoming,
yes,
when we're together.
Thank you, Lord. Yes, we're gonna have a homecoming. We're gonna have a homecoming, church.
We're gonna
walk on streets of gold. Yeah.
We're gonna sing with
you. Gonna sing with all of heaven's angels.
See all the secrets.
Gonna see every secret heaven's gonna hold.
We're gonna get to see my
yeah.
And hold Jesus.
Gonna hold to his nail-scarred hand.
Oh, what a great homecoming when we're together.
How many believe we're going to have a homecoming?
We're going to have a homecoming. We're going to walk streets of gold.
Going to walk on streets of gold.
We're going to sing with the angels.
Going to sing with all the heaven's angels.
Yes,
thank you, Lord.
We're gonna get to see Mama.
Gonna see Mamas and Daddies.
And hold Jesus' hand.
Gonna hold to his nail-scarred hand.
Oh, what a great homecoming when we're together again. Oh, what a great homecoming.
Heaven, heaven's land.
Aren't you looking forward to it? Aren't you looking forward to your homecoming in glory? I tell you, that's something to shout about tonight. That's something to get excited about, ain't it? We're gonna have a homecoming.
Yeah.
We're gonna walk streets of gold.
Gonna walk on streets of gold.
We're gonna sing with the
angels. Gonna sing with all of heaven's angels.
All the secrets heaven.
Gonna see every secret. Yes, we are.
Gonna get to see.
Gonna see Mamas and Daddies.
great homecoming is when we're together.
Come on, everybody stand up and help us.
We're gonna have a homecoming. Yeah. We're gonna walk streets.
Gonna walk on streets of gold.
We're gonna sing with.
Gonna sing with all of heaven's angels.
See all the secrets.
We're gonna see every secret. Heaven's gonna have the whole. We're gonna see mamas and daddies.
Yeah. And hold Jesus. Yeah. Oh, what a great home. When we're together again.
Up in heaven's land.
Oh, what a great homecoming.
Here in heaven's land.
Heaven's land.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Oh, there's going to be a great homecoming. I wish somebody shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah. Somebody just shout hallelujah. 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 Somebody just lift your hands and shout it. Somebody proclaim it. Somebody proclaim it. Somebody proclaim it. Somebody proclaim it. Holy One, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One. I just wish somebody put your hands together for Jesus and give Jesus a hand clap of praise. Oh, you need to celebrate with Jesus. This has been one of the greatest weeks. Testimonies, what God has done. And you know, it's been good what God done this week. But we're going to see the greatest thing tonight to take place. For two or three weeks now, I've been waiting with expectation for this one night of camp meeting. Yes, the other has been good, but I'm ready for what God's going to do in this place tonight. If you're ready for what God is going to do in this place tonight, put your hands together. And celebrate it, celebrate it, celebrate it.
Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. I took back what he stole from me. I took back what he stole from me. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. I said, he's under my feet, he's under my feet, he's under my feet, he's under my feet. He's under my feet, he's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. I took back what he stole from me. I took back what he stole from me. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. I said he's under my feet, he's under my feet. He's under my feet, he's under my feet, he's under my feet, he's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. I took back what he stole from me. I took back what he stole from me. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what he stole from me. I said he's under my feet, 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 he's under my feet. Satan is under my feet. Come on and look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Well, he healed my body and he touched my mind. He saved me, it was just in time. So I'm gonna praise his name. His name is just the same. Why don't you come on and praise him? Look what the Lord has done. Come on and look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Well, he promised me when I was on my knees he would save my family. So I'm gonna praise his name. His name is just the same. Why don't you come on and praise him? Look what the Lord has done. Come on and look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Well, he healed my body and he touched my mind. He saved me, it was just in time. So I'm gonna praise his name. His name is just the same.
Why don't you come on and praise him? Look what the Lord has done. Come on and look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Well, he promised me when I was on my knees, he would save my family. So I'm gonna praise his name. His name is just the same. Why don't you come on and praise him? Look what the Lord has done. Come on and look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Well, he healed my body and he touched my mind. He saved me, it was just in time. So I'm gonna praise his name. His name is just the same. Why don't you come on and praise him? Look what the Lord has done. Come on and look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. Well, he promised me when I was on my knees, he would save my family. So I'm gonna praise his name. His name is just the same. Why don't you come on and praise him? Look what the Lord has done. Lord, I just wanna thank you. Lord, I just wanna thank you. Lord, I just wanna thank you. I wanna thank you for being so good to me. You've been so good, so good, so good. Oh, you've been so good to me. So good, so good, so good, so good. Oh, you've been so good to me. And Lord, I just wanna thank you. 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 I wanna thank you for being so good to me. And Lord, I just wanna thank you.
About it, but I know this week there's been somebody that got a miracle from God, and if you was that somebody that got a miracle from God, I just want you to throw your hands up, throw your hands up, and just go ahead and thank him for it.
I said everything that happened to me, that is good, God did it, God. Oh yes he did,
oh yes he did.
I said everything that
I was lost out in a world of sin.
God did it.
God did it.
Oh, yes, he did.
God's still doing it. I'm just telling y'all right now what I feel in my spirit. Before this service is over with, the spirit of cancer walked in, but the spirit of cancer will leave. But it won't leave here the way it come in. It will leave here by a force that is pushing it out. It will not come in here, it come in here on a physical body, but it's going out here on the spoken word. And before this service is over with, arthritis that come in on somebody's body, it's not going to go out in somebody's body. It's going to go out on the spoken word, because God is going to bring liberation to somebody's life. I want somebody to throw your hands up and say, let it be so. Whatever your need is, whatever your need is, whatever your need is. Some of you got problems with your kids, problems with your husband, your wife, your mother and father. You got problems with your boss, man. You ain't got no problem when you got God on your side. You ain't got no problem when you got God on your side. And I'm just telling y'all now, and we're serving notice on the devil right now, that God is in the midst of us tonight, and God is going to do some great and mighty things before this service is over with. Somebody put your hands together for Jesus. Brother Maurice Hart, hallelujah, you may be seated at this time. I just thank God for this service tonight. Before this service is over with, it's going to be one of the most unusual, outstanding services you've ever been in before. Hallelujah, and I just thank God for President Maurice Hart. Hallelujah, a spiritual father. I have a bunch of spiritual fathers that just, that just keep me going in faith. And when I see these men of God, hallelujah, and I just thank God for what God is doing. Thank God for the many leaders and ministers that Brother Hart has encouraged over the period of years and got behind and support. And I thank God for people that love other people. I want you to put your hands together for my friend.
Thank you, Pastor. I'd like for the board members of Anchor Bay that are here, please come. And if I call your name, would you please come? This is license and ordination time. And thank you. Okay. Okay. Dave Russell, would you come? Stand and face the pulpit. D. Malcor. Chris, you know your last name. Praise God. Some of these are coming into our fellowship, and we like to set them aside. They've proven ministries, but thank God they come in fellowship. We don't proselyte. We like for them to come in because they want to come in. Cliff Pierce. Brother Sherlock Bailey.
Bailey. Glory to God.
Get some new shoes. Hallelujah. Brother Kevin Jones. If there's anybody that has received your papers from the office and you have not had hands laid upon you, would you please come at this time? Sister Janelle Wade is going to read you the charge. Sister Wade.
Thank you, brother. Praise God. This is always such a tremendous high privilege for me to be in the presence of such awesome people and in the presence of God to read the charge to you laid before you. In 2 Timothy chapter 4, I want you to listen very much and very hard and very deep, because the ministry belongs to God. Amen. I charge you therefore before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, who will judge the living and the dead at his appearing in his kingdom. Preach the word. Be ready in season and out of season. I want to stop right there. If you're belonging to Anchor Bay or coming to these kind of fellowships and these kind of conferences, you better be in season, because you never know when they're going to call on you. Amen. Convince, rebuke, exhort with all longsuffering and teaching. For the time will come when they'll not endure sound doctrine, but according to their own desires, because they have itching ears, they will heap up for themselves teachers, and they will turn their ears away from the truth and be turned aside to fables. But you be watchful in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of evangelists, fulfill your ministry. I want you to know tonight, like Dr. Hart has always said, it won't make you a minister what we're doing tonight. We didn't call you. We can't do anything but pray and lay hands on you and give you the charge of the gospel of Jesus Christ. And I thank God for every one of you and everyone in this house that can tell one person that they don't have to be the same that they are, that there's a way out, and his name is Jesus. Tell the world, tell everyone you meet about Jesus Christ. You got some good news to tell them. Amen. Dr. Hart.
Would you stand as we lay hands upon these? Brother Ralph and Brother Doyle, would you please come with us? Thank God for the word. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. You heard the charge. Open your heart to the Lord. Your ministry, many of you have been in the ministry a long time, and you're coming into our fellowship. We thank God for you. And I want you to know, I'm your friend. My phone number is listed in the book in Omaha, Nebraska. It's also listed in the Anchor Bay book. You can reach me. You can talk to me. But most of all, we can talk to God. Amen. Hallelujah. Would you stretch your hands toward these as we pray? Heavenly Father, as we lay hands upon these tonight that have dedicated their life to the ministry of the tearing down of the powers of Satan, I thank you for the anointing of the Holy Ghost to rest upon them. Dear God, open their understanding to the word. Make them sharp, dear God, in the things of God. Give them wisdom and knowledge to tear down the works of Satan, to undo the heavy burden, to let the oppressed go free. Dear Jesus, I thank you tonight that you have never failed. And your anointing sets people free. Your anointing destroys the yoke. Let that anointing come upon these, dear God, as never before. I thank you tonight for the quickening of the Holy Ghost. I thank you for your spirit in them to manifest your word. Dear God, in Jesus' name we pray. Oh Lord, they've heard the charge. They've said yes to the charge. Dear God, now give them the ability to fulfill the ministry that you have called them to. We'll thank you for it. Amen and amen. Welcome. Welcome. Praise God. Welcome. Welcome. Praise God. Chris, I'm glad you know your last name. Praise God. God bless you. Welcome. God bless you. Welcome. You can be seated. Praise God. Praise God.
Oh, hallelujah. Somebody give Jesus a hand clap. Give Jesus a hand clap. I just thank God for men, hallelujah, that set themselves aside. Hallelujah. Brother Ralph, if you and Brother Maurice and Brother Doyle will come here a second. Hallelujah. I just thank God for men of faith. There's men, then there's men of faith, and then there's great men of faith. And I just thank God for, which in my life, that there are some men of faith. Which are not just small men of faith, but great men of faith that's taught me how to believe and trust God. You people say, Pastor, you just got big faith. Well, you know where I got it from? I got it from great men of God. Got it from great men of God to great men of faith. When your brother Shane, oh, Holy One. Thank you, Jesus. And tonight, I just want to present to to these great men of faith. Over 250 years of ministry standing here. Over 200, and I'm not saying that to make anybody feel old. I'm just saying we got some men of faith in the house. Hallelujah. And I would just like for my dad to know I love him. He already knows it. And I just thank God for Brother Hart's. Hallelujah. There are men that has put faith into my life. And I know that the Hart's has put a lot of faith in me. And I thank God for my dad that put faith in me over the period of years. And I just want to honor them with a little gift that says Heroes of Faith. Because I can't tell you who all the sports guys are. I can't even tell you who the number one basketball player is tonight. I can't tell you who the number one football player is. Oh, but I can tell you about some heroes of faith. I can tell you about some men of God. Just that's taught me how to trust God. And hallelujah. And it just says hero of faith, Reverend Jimmy Dobbs, 50 years of ministry, Paxton Revivals in a Church, 2001, Winter Camp Meeting. I just thank God for all that he has done and all that he is doing. And for Brother Dohart, just 62 years old, is all you are. 62 years of ministry. 62 years. Not yesterday. Some of you ain't even 62 years old. Some of you are not even 62 years old. And I just thank God. And then Brother Ralph, 62 years of ministry. Fought the good fight of faith. And which is the young one on the block, 64 years of ministry. Brother Maurice Hart, 64 years in fighting faith. I wish somebody just celebrate. I wish somebody just celebrate. Oh, you can do better than that. Celebrate with us. Celebrate with us. Celebrate with us. Oh, do that again. Over 250 years of ministry standing right here. I just thank God. I just thank God that these men of God, and as I begin to think about my mom and my dad, taught me what God was all about. Hallelujah. You know why I believe in a big God? Because my mom and daddy told me there was a big God. Hallelujah. My mom and daddy didn't lie to me about God either. No, he bigger than what they really told me he was. You know, I found him, and it wasn't that they wasn't telling me he was a big God. I couldn't imagine him because I never had to trust him to be a big God, but I trust him to be a big God, and he's just that. And I just thank God, and I know that you give a mic to four preachers, we may never get it back. But I just like my dad to say something to you because he's a man of faith and the father of this house, and I just like thank God for the word that my mom and dad's put in me and these Hart brothers has put in me.
Brother Steve, I do praise God. I'm saved. I praise God that within 30 days after I was saved, I was preaching the gospel. I didn't know John 3:16, but I hit the streets. All I knew to preach, get right with God or you're going to hell. Still a good message. Don't hear much of it, but I thank God for men of God like these that I've met. They're sticking by it, sticking to the guns. One day at the end of the road, we'll meet the Lord. We'll hear him say, well done. Well done, thy good and faithful servant. I praise God for all of you tonight. Back us up. Keep on going with us. God bless you.
And the young one here, which he used to run with some boys in the choir. They was called Bonnie and Clyde.
Good God Almighty. The greatest thing in all the world is to know that you're saved. Great God in heaven. Jesus has never failed. He has never changed. He's still the same. Praise God.
Brother Maurice, Brother Dahl, Brother Dobbs, two Brother Dobbses. It's an honor for me to be in your midst tonight. Something great's going to happen here tonight. I just feel his presence so real. Amen.
I thank God for this man. When I was laid up with a stroke and a heart attack, this man came to Los Angeles And I didn't know he is coming. He just said, God told me to come and help you. And he came and preached for me when I couldn't preach. And I thank God for you, Brother Steve.
Yeah. Glory.
And I know what God is going to do tonight, for I feel him way down in my soul.
Amen.
If you will turn your faith loose and begin to praise him. There's a man that's sitting back there. He's on oxygen tonight. But God spoke to me and said, you're coming off of that tank. And I'm going to heal you tonight. There's some of you with heart trouble. God said, I'm going to heal you. Some of you got kidney trouble. Some of you got all kinds of sickness. But tonight, God said, this is your night. You come to leave it at the altar and to glorify God. Raise your hand and just give him praise for these men of God that have built this great work.
Oh, somebody begin to praise him for these great men of God. We love y'all. Love you, every one of you. Oh, hallelujah. Let's give him a hand clap of honor and respect. Put your hands together. I wish everybody just stand to your feet. Stand at your feet and put your hands together for Jesus. Oh, Holy One. Holy One. Oh, give it up for Eddie Lee and Anointa. They will be with us Sunday morning and Sunday night for the home folks.
Yes. You know, before we sing this song, I've got a little bit of a testimony to tell about what God did since I've been here at Paxson Revival. I was telling Brother Ralph about it. And, you know, all this week we've been praying and really seeking God, and God has been moving. And I tell you, Brother Ralph, the other night he was saying, if you'll give $101, God's going to move for you. And I thought, Lord, we don't even have $101. We come down here on faith and we really don't have it. But I told Marsha, I said, go ahead and give it. I said, we're going to give what we got. So we gave $101. We went back to the hotel room that night. And when we got to the hotel room, there was a message to call a gentleman in Michigan. And we called the gentleman in Michigan, and he says, Brother Eddie, he said, God's been speaking to my heart. And he says, for about 2 weeks now, God spoke to me. 2 weeks ago, I decided, God said, I want you to buy Eddie Lee and Anointed a brand new bus. And he said, I want you to do it, and I'm going to give you the ability to do that. So he said he called up churches, called up he said friends of his that were millionaires. He started calling them up, and they said, we'll love to help. Just everybody that he's called, he said, we're going to be a part of that. And he said, I want y'all to come down in May. And he said, when y'all come down in May and do a concert, he said, I'm going to present the check to you to buy your bus. That's God, amen? So don't tell me you can outgive God, amen? Last night we was giving in the altar offering, and I gave everything I had, everything, every bit of cash in my pocket. And so we get up this morning to come to church, and Barry said, we need gas. I said, I don't have no more money. I gave it all. And he said, all right, we'll just go on faith. So we got here this morning on faith. I was sitting up here, and Marty comes and hands me a check for $200. That's God. Nobody knew it. That's God. And I said today, I said, I can't wait to get the packs in tonight so I can give some more. Amen. So if you got it, I tell you, I don't know what y'all come to do tonight, but I didn't come to be seen. I didn't come to have a good time, but I come to praise the Lord, didn't you? How many come to praise him tonight? Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah.
Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
There's a dear old saint in our church. She loves to praise the Lord. There's a dear old saint in our church. She loves to praise the Lord. There's a dear old saint in our church. She loves to praise the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Where did you come to praise him?
Hallelujah.
Well, I love to run and dance and shout. I love to run and dance and shout.
I love to praise the Lord. Well, I love to run and dance and shout. I love to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Where did you come to praise him tonight? Well, I don't know what you came to do. I can't. Where did you come to praise him? I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise. Well, glory. I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Well, the Holy Ghost is in this place. I came, yeah, the Holy Ghost is in this place. I came to praise the Lord. Well, the Holy Ghost is in this place. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do we got any shouters here tonight? How many people here shout? How many bleezing shout? Well, I tell you, some of you's lost your shout and need it back again. Amen. I believe we need to shout in this place. Hallelujah. Well, I love to run and dance, shout. I love to praise. Well, glory. I love to run and dance, shout. I love to praise the Lord. Well, I love to run and dance, shout. I love to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Well, the Holy Ghost is in this place. I came to praise the Lord. Well, the Holy Ghost is in this place. I came to praise the Lord. Well, the Holy Ghost is in this place. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. One more time, did you come to praise him? Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came, yeah. I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Well, I don't know what you came to do. I came to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Yes. Glory, 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 glory. Praise God, hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, I don't know what you came to do, but I come to praise the Lord. I come to praise the Lord. Oh, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One. I just wish somebody make devil mad shout hallelujah. I wish you make a real man shout hallelujah two times. Oh, somebody's going to leave this place changed. You may be seated. I just thank God for all of you that's come. The largest turnout that we've ever had at Winter Camp Meeting, 120-something out-of-town ministers, and just thank God for all of those that's come from all the different states across America that come, other countries that come. I just thank God for all those that were here. But I thank God for those that are still here. Hallelujah, because those that are here tonight is going to get what God has in store. As God spoke to me over 3 weeks ago that miracles were moving into this church, since then we have heard testimonies after testimonies of healing, of cancer, of tumors, which in a magnitude that I have never seen in the ministry. I've never seen three go into hospital in one day and all three come out, and none of them cut on. None of them cut on. Why? I just believe between now and the end of the year, as God has spoken, 50 days of revival, I just believe if we will stay in this, and so for the pastors and evangelists that are here, take this spirit of revival back with you. Take the spirit of deliverance back with you. Everywhere you go, don't be afraid to believe it. Don't be afraid to speak it. You'll speak it. He'll do it. Somebody give Jesus a hand clap. Brother Welton, if you, we want you to sing tonight, Brother Welton. Oh, Holy One. But before you sing, my grandson wants to sing to you. All right?
I don't know of any man that is more inspiring, well, besides my father-in-law, of course, but Brother Welton is such a blessing to us. I know the church members love him. My son wanted to sing a song to Brother Welton. Today he was on the keyboard, and he said he needed a microphone. He was trying to mock Brother Welton. And kids know the true love of God, and they don't see color, they don't see hatred, and Brother Welton's connected with my son, and I appreciate his ministry and his inspiring my son and myself to go further in music ministry, and he wants to sing a song.
And also, you have to understand, for some of you, then you never hear Pastor Welton talk about this, but he's got more kids in his house than some of you got in your neighborhood, and it ain't because they're all his. He's taking all these kids in off the street, taking all the abused little girls that their father had violated them year after year after year, and he tucked them in and loved them like a daddy should. And this is what this song's about.
Lay your head or where you call your home. I don't know where you eat your meals or where you talk on the phone. I don't know if you got a cook, a butler, or a maid. I don't know if you have a yard with a hammock in the shade. I don't know if you got a shelter, say a place to hide. I don't know if you live with friends whom you can't confide. I don't know if you got a family, say a mom or dad. I don't know if you have love, but I bet you wish you had. Come and go with me to Brother Welton's house. Come and go with me to Brother Welton's house. It's a big, big house with lots and lots of food. A big, big table with lots and lots of food. A big, big yard where we can play football. A big, big house, it's Brother Welton's house. Brother Welton's house.
I wish you'd put your hands together for Brother Welton. I wish everybody just stretch your hands towards Brother Welton. Just stretch your hands. Just speak faith into him. Speak faith towards him. Oh, y'all need to all stand up to your feet. Y'all all need to stand up to your feet. If you're a member of this church, get up on your feet and stretch your hands towards Brother Welton. Speak faith to him. Speak faith to him. God's going to do something for Brother Welton tonight.
I feel good. Something about me, Jesus. Something about me, Jesus. Something about King Jesus will make me feel good. Yeah, I feel good. I feel good. I feel good because there's something about my Jesus, something about my Jesus, something about King Jesus that make me feel good. Hey, I feel good. I feel good. Hey. Something about King Jesus, something about my Jesus, something about King Jesus, make me feel good. Hey, look what the Lord has done, look what the Lord has done. He healed my body, touched my mind, he saved me. just in time. I gotta praise his name. Every day is just the same. I'm gonna praise him. Look what the Lord has done. Hey, look what the Lord has done. Look what the Lord has done. He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just the same. I gotta praise his name. Every day is just the same. I'm gonna praise him. Look what the Lord has done. 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 He healed my body. He touched my mind. He saved me just in time. I'm gonna praise his name. Every day is just the same. I've gotta praise him. Look what the Lord has done.
Somebody need to rejoice. Somebody need to rejoice. Somebody need to rejoice. It's camp meeting. We'll be right back.
time, waiting patiently in line. He was there all the time. The time I went looking for peace in some void, I was trying to blame all my ills on this world I lived in. Surface relationship, Lord, they used me. I was done in. All the time, Jesus, thank you, was waiting to free me from my sin. He was there all the time. Right. Waiting patiently in line. He was there all the time. When it seems your burden are too hard to bear, he was there. I said, when it seems, your burden is just too hard for you to bear, he was there all the time,
You listen to this man. Many years ago, I had my tent in Houston, Texas. His father and mother and sisters worked for me. They sung in my service, and one night he came to me crying. And he said, Brother Hart, I can't do anything. Will you pray for me that God will give me a talent? And God will bless me. I laid hands on his hands, and I said, Weldon, I want you to play the organ. He went home. The next night, his father came to me and said, Brother Hart, if you don't do something with that boy, I'm going to kill him. He said he sat up all night pecking on the piano. But that night, he came and played the organ with two fingers, one hand. The next night, one hand over here and one over here, and the third night, he put his foot on the pedals and began to play. The Spirit of God was in that man, and God began to bless him. I closed my meeting and went away. And some weeks or months later, I went to, I guess it was Louisville, is that right? Went to Louisville. Somebody said, Weldon is playing in the nightclub here. And I said, Weldon Lane? And they said, yes. I went to the nightclub and stood in the back of the door. And he was singing and playing. He stopped in the middle of it, and all of a sudden he said, folks, turn around and look at that man right back there in the back of this building. He laid hands on me, and God, give me this talent that I've got. And a drunk man sitting on the stool said, Brother, will you lay hands on me? But I told Weldon, I said, son, God didn't put you and give you this talent to play in the world. He said, but I'm under contract.
And as soon as this contract wears out, I'm going to go out and work for God. I don't know where to go. I said, you can come to me if you want to, because God has got his hand on him. And how many think that God has given him a talent? You've never heard a musician play like he played, a singer like he sings. And this is a God-given gift, and I want you to praise God for him right now. And Brother Weldon hasn't told you, but he has a condition in his body. Unless God intervenes, he would die. But I gave him a word last night. I want you to stretch your hands towards him right now. And stand on your feet and say, God, heal his body. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God, the same God that gave him this talent and the devil's trying to take it away, I pray the Spirit of God fall upon him right now from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet. Heal every fiber in his being. Kill every germ that's in that body. Smite the powers of Satan, and God will give you praise. You said when our praises go up, our miracle come down. And this church is praising you for the healing of Brother Weldon right now. Come on and praise God.
I wish I could get somebody to help me rejoice and praise. You say he's a pastor. Why do you think the devil want to take him out? Why do you think the devil want to bring him down? But I thank God tonight's miracle night.
Yes.
I thank God, brother, tonight's miracle night. You come all the way to Florida, and your liver is not what it's supposed to be. And the doctor said you ain't going to live, but I'm telling you, healing's in the house tonight. Healing is in the house tonight. Healing is in the house tonight. I just wish somebody shout, God's right now, God. God's a right now God. Oh, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One, Holy One. Healing in this place tonight. Healing in this place tonight. Oh, look at somebody and say, get ready to be healed. Get ready to be changed. Get ready. Oh, Holy One, you may be seated. I just felt all week long that tonight is going to be something that we're going to talk about for years. Y'all remember that Friday night at camp meeting, 2001? Now, y'all remember that night? Yeah. Telling you God's going to do something. And right before the Hart brothers come up, make sure you go by the table, which Eddie Lee and the Anointed got their tapes and their videos and their T-shirts and stuff, and you heard them tonight. It wouldn't hurt you to slide a hamburger money their way, and God will bless you. Brother Sherlock, if you'll come and we'll just greet the folks and tell them about your brand-new book that just come in today. Hallelujah. I just fell in love with this brother. He's a man of God. That's a preaching word that'll get you set on fire. Get you set on fire. Put your hands together for this man of God.
The biggest question that I'm asked as I travel this country in prophecy conferences with Hal Lindsey and Zola Levitt and Chuck Missler and these men is this: is America mentioned in prophecy? 3 weeks before the tragedy happened, my book on Where Does America Fit was published. And I want to tell you this. God has a special plan for America.
Yes, he does, yes.
I want to say that again. God has a special plan for America.
Yes, he does.
Osama bin Laden, that's my new name for him, did not attack America because we're capitalists. They attacked America because of two things. There's still a consciousness of God in this nation. And our money, it doesn't say in Allah we trust, in God we trust. Can somebody say amen? And the second thing is we've stood with the Jewish people up to this time. There are two reasons why God has blessed this nation. I want you to understand that America has a prominent place in prophecy. It's in my book. Make sure and get it. Also, we wrote a newsletter. Every month we write a prophecy newsletter. This month was on the brothers in conflict. Be sure and get that. It's free of charge on the back. And if you'd like to get information about our prophecy school, I want to say to Pastor Dobbs, what a glorious time to bring God's servants together. What a glory. I believe tonight miracles are going to explode in this house. Can I tell you one more thing? Can I tell you one more thing? This picture just blew me away. I want you to check this out. Hey, don't criticize Peter for stepping out of the boat and falling. Criticize the 11 dumb disciples for sitting in the boat. Can I say something else? Even though Peter fell, he was closer to Jesus in falling than the 11 disciples were in the boat. So when you follow God, trust me, you're not going to sink. You're going to make it. Thank you very much. Hey, God bless you, brother.
I want you to stand to your feet. Put your hands together for the hearts. Hallelujah. You're going to be blessed tonight. Just get your heart in tune for a miracle in your body, your life, your spirit tonight. Because tonight is more than just a title of a miracle service. It's going to be manifested in this service.
How many feels the presence of God? How many knows that God is present with you? See, we can hear testimonies about somebody else being healed. You can hear how God raised me from dead. You can hear how God gave me a massive heart attack and God healed me of it. All things works together for the good of them that love the Lord, which are called according to his purpose. So every problem you have in life, remember, bad things happen to good people. God's in it. Sometimes it's God's way of teaching you how to trust him. While you're standing because you're able to stand on your two legs. God's able, you that are sitting, to heal you tonight. Tonight is miracle night. Brother Eddie Lee, you heard the story, how he gave $101. You know how much a new bus costs? The best used bus you can find is around $30,000 or $40,000. A new bus, over $100,000. A man called him on the phone. He didn't call the man called him, says, when he got home after giving what God told him to give. And then he got over a new bus, whatever it cost. That cost a lot of money. $300,000. Let me tell you something. How big is your God? How big is your God? How big is your God? Your God that made the world. Your God that breathed life into your body. How big is your God? How big is he? He's a great big God. Listen. Millionaires are born of God, the people that want to be millionaires. You have the right place in mind. God's hand can make you what you want to be. If you'll dedicate your life to God, if you'll open your heart to God, if you'll be a giver and not just a canner. Canner never gets so much and that's all. It's canned, that's it. But when God begins to use you, when God begins to bless you, don't forget where it's coming from. Every time God blesses you, give to God. You can't give too much to God. Listen, I don't know whether you've been able to go back here and eat or not. I don't know whether you've been able to live in the hotel or not. But all of these preachers, 127 of them, it cost a lot of money just to pay the hotel bill. We come because we love this place. We come because it's of God. I said, we come because of that. I thank God for it. If I had to pay my own hotel bill, I'd still come. You know why? Because I've found this is a place where God meets his people. This is a place where you get discouraged. Thank God you can be lifted up. The messages I've heard since I've been here are worth all the time that I've spent getting here. Worth the money I've spent on the airplane getting here. It's worth everything. And I thank you live here where it's at. You live here in this town. I thank God for the members of this church. I thank God for the wonderful ladies back there that prepared that food every day. That's a ministry. I said, that's a ministry. Amen. And did all you preachers enjoy that ministry? You're the fruits. You take a partaker of it. But on the top of that, listen, the souls has been blessed. Tonight, I'm going to tell you something. There's sick bodies here that won't go out here sick. A massive heart attack. No hope to live. I said, no hope to live. Told my brothers. I couldn't live. Brother Doyle, Brother Maurice, Brother Raymond, they stood by my bedside. They come to the hospital when I was there, and no hope for me. In fact, I was on intensive care, and the heart thing was on me, and I saw it. Life was going out of my body. I tried to get somebody. I couldn't get my brother saw me. Doyle standing out in that hallway saw me, and he said, get somebody. I'm going to see my brother. I said, you can't go in there. He said, watch me. Come across there, come inside, and found my needle was unplugged. Somebody had unplugged me. Only God preserved my life.
Yeah.
Listen, raised from dead, pronounced dead, in the morgue. If God will do it for me, He'll do it for you.
Yeah.
I said, He'll do it for you. That's the great part. Only one got healed at the Pool of Bethesda. Only one. There was multitudes. Multitudes that were sick, but only one got it. Tonight, you're that one that God's going to heal. Have me say, Brother Hart, I need a supernatural miracle of God. Could I see your hand?
Mighty God.
I'm going to ask you tonight to bring off. I could say $20, but normally that's what anybody asks for. I want you to give an unusual gift. I want you to give whatever God speaks to your heart.
Praise God. Praise God. Oh, glory. Give me my Bible. Let me get my gun. You turn 15 off.
Amen. Amen. Now we got it.
This is the one we'll use tonight. Jeremiah chapter 32, verses 26 and 27, read. Then came the word of the Lord unto Jeremiah, saying, Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Everybody say, all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me? This is miracle night. You have to do something if you want to get a miracle. I said, you have to do something if you're going to get a miracle. You're not going to sit like a bump on a log and God give you a miracle. God's looking for people that will open up. He's looking for people that will say, here am I. God, you know what I need. Now praise Him for it. As you praise God, He said, I'm the Lord, the God of all flesh, and there is nothing too hard for me. When you realize it's God that does the work, it's not man. And we're just a channel. When we tell you God's word, God will perform His word if you will let Him. See, a lot of people don't want God to perform His word. I courted Sister Hart 2.5 years before we got married. I would ask her every night when I took her home, give me a kiss. And she'd say, uh-uh. That's for my husband. But the day we got married, I didn't ask her. She let me. I want you to know God is looking for people that will let Him. That will let Him bless them. That will let Him fill their life. That will let Him break the bands of wickedness. That will let Him undo the heavy burden. That will let Him.
Change will come when you let God take over. When you think about it, Hezekiah was going to die. And they told him he's going to die. Prophet had told him he's going to die. But he turned his face to the wall and said, God, I got to have a change. I want a change. And the prophet turned around and came back and said, God's going to give you so many more years. When you are in a trouble, and when you are in trouble and sickness or pain or suffering or poverty has got you, all you got to do is to get a hold to God and a change will come. A night will not come. Fear will not come. But God will come. The angel of the Lord will step in.
He said, the angel of the Lord encampeth around about them that fear Him and keep His commandments. If you want God to do something for you, you just make up your mind that you're going to have what God's got for you. Your healing is what God's got for you. The anointing is what God's got for you. I'm not just y'all. Sit down. I want you to know it's time you recognize that God's got something and you can have it. I say you can have what God's got for you. Don't let the devil destroy.
Prophet Isaiah says it's not by might. David had his mighty men of valor. He said it's not by power. Samson had power, but he said it's by my spirit. It's by my spirit. The spirit will overtake the flesh every time. The spirit is what's going to heal you. This flesh is dead. This flesh will die. But God said, my spirit will live and will live forever. Let's give him the praise. Let's give him the glory.
When you begin to praise God, then God will begin to work. The church today has gone to a ritual and to a form and to a rut. But God's glory wants to come down. As in my church one night, suddenly a ball of fire began to spin in this side of the building. It circled the building, went back, and was over a woman. And I said, woman, is there something wrong? She said, I've been a cripple for 12 years. And said, somebody told me if I'd come here tonight that you'd pray for me and God would heal me. I haven't walked for 12 years. I haven't been out of bed for 12 years. She said, will you pray? I said, no, I won't pray. The Holy Ghost has already done it. And all of a sudden, she jumped over the bench, landed in the aisle, ran around the church three times, and out the door she went. I said, my God, what happened to that woman? But on Tuesday after Sunday, somebody buzzed my door. And I went down, and this woman said, look here, had a handful of papers. When you told me I was healed, I went back to the same doctor I've been going to for 12 years. And he said, there's nothing wrong. You are healed. I don't care what you've done. I don't care where you've gone. There's a God that wants to heal.
The Bible says, why sit we here until we die? I don't know what you come for tonight, but I didn't come to sit. I didn't come to stay where I'm at. I didn't come to stay where I've been. Where we're going, we ain't here sitting and dying. Brother Welton, we ain't sitting and dying. Come here, man. We ain't sitting here dying. We're going to live to show forth the glory of God.
He said, I'm the same today as I was yesterday. I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. Is anything too hard for God? I don't care what the devil try. God said, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. He said, I've come that you shall live. Live and not die. Life is in you. Joy is in you. He didn't bring you this far to leave you. He said, I'll never forleave you. I'll never forsake you. Lo, I am with you. He said, I'm with you. I'm with you.
For the Lord thy God is mighty in the midst of thee. He will save. He will do the work that's within you that you need. Because God is joying over you with singing. He has your best interest at heart. He said, I will rest in my love. Because in his love is all of the provision. Everything that you have needed is already provided in the rest of
God. When God gives you an order, it's going to take place.
Somebody shout, yeah!
There was a lady with an issue of blood. Not just the blood, but an issue of blood. See, when you have blood problems, you have issue problems. The Bible says she was behind. Somebody say behind. Ever felt like you were behind? Somebody was slicker. Somebody was quicker. Somebody had more. She was behind. But then she looked up. She saw Jesus. Behind ain't so bad if Jesus is up front. Or can I get somebody to say amen? The Bible says that she began to talk to herself. Can I say it again? She began to talk to herself. Sometimes the preacher ain't around. Sometimes the pastor ain't around. Sometimes the prophet ain't around. You gotta talk to yourself. You gotta say, self, 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 self. I've been sick too long. I've been bound too long. I need a miracle. Sell!
She touched the hem of his garment, and Jesus made her ever with whole. When you touch the garment of God, when you reach up and you can't see anything, you can't feel anything, you don't know anything, there is a God that's looking down. He got a change for you.
God, Peter said, if I could just walk down the streets in Jerusalem, my shadow will overshadow them and make them whole. You need healing tonight. All Peter needs to do is pass your way. He's coming by. He's coming by. Moses said, I'll take my rod. I've got it in my rod. I'll walk to the sea. I'll divide the waters.
Moses had it in his rod. Jesus had it in his garment. My God, if you just touch the hem of the garment, you was made whole of whatsoever disease you had. Old Peter said, I'll come by Main Street, and everybody that I pass by get healed on my shadow. My God, tonight. How many of you want to be healed?
Everybody wants to be healed.
Everybody. The lady said they've come to take my sons. They've come, they're going to sell them as bondsmen. What do you have? She said, I don't have anything but a little oil. He said, gather the vessels. Let me tell you.
Look behind you. This man has took the thing out of his nose. Hey! Glory! Hallelujah! 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 Glory! 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 Thank God. Go ahead. Go ahead and praise him. Go ahead and praise him. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God.
I want you to breathe and shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Turn me up. Somebody turn this thing up. Shout hallelujah again.
Hallelujah.
Can you breathe?
Yeah, I can breathe.
You don't have
to breathe better than I did when I come in here with that thing.
You can breathe better with it out than when it's in.
Yeah.
I want you to jump up and down and say, God, I've got victory right now. Woo!
There's nothing that God can't do. Go ahead and praise him. That's how you have victory. Begin to praise God. Praise God for the miracle you have need of. Praise God. Right back here, just praise God. It's all right to praise him. It's all right to glorify his name. The devil don't like it, so do it anyhow. Go ahead and praise God. Give God glory for it. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you. Victory is yours. Victory is yours. Victory is yours. Victory is yours. Thank God.
Hallelujah, for this law of the Spirit of life that's in Christ Jesus hath made me free from the law of sin and death. Therefore, life is flowing in the house tonight. Life is flowing in the body. Life is flowing in the body of Christ. Life is flowing tonight because it's lived. It's made us free.
I don't know if y'all feel what I feel in this place, but I feel miracles of expectation. Hallelujah. This pastor, where are you at, pastor? Hallelujah. When he come, the word come to me, and I don't know how, and you're correct. Hallelujah. But the doctor does not give you no hope, right?
Amen.
And he come and says, I'm coming. I'm coming. I'm coming to Florida for a miracle. I'm coming to Florida for a miracle. The doctors, hallelujah, don't want him to travel. He's on a waiting list for a transplant. But why have something transplanted that belonged to somebody else when God can restore his? I wish I could get some faith in this building. I wish I could get somebody believing. We speak love.
Right now, right now, right now, right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. If you've got cancer or you've got heart trouble, if you'll come right now, you're going to be set free. Right now. Heart trouble or cancer. Either one. Heart trouble or cancer. Come on now. The power of God is here. The healing spirit of God is here. Dear God, the devil's a liar. He'll remember this date as long as he lives because he's going to live. Cancer, we come against you in Jesus' name by the power and the authority of God now. Now, turn me up. Now, Lord. Now, Lord. Now, Lord. Now, Lord. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Now, it's done. It's done. It's done. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. If God can heal heart trouble, he can heal cancer.
Brother Ralph, this man that the doctors didn't want him to come, what was wrong with you?
My liver. They
want to replace your liver.
Yes.
And God healed this man. I said, how do you know? He said, I had no energy. I couldn't do anything. I want you to run over, touch that wall, and run back and grab me. Thank God. Get out of his way. Get out of his way. My God, my God. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Ha, ha. Hallelujah. No wonder the devil didn't want him to come. You got your miracle. You got your miracle. Thank you.
Go ahead, lift your hands. It's going to be done now. What? Heart failure. Well, if you got heart failure, you could be up here.
That's why I'm here.
That's what?
I'm here because I've come from my ear. I came to this meeting for this.
It's done. I'm telling you, it's done. Go ahead. Jump. Do anything you want. That's right. Go ahead. Hallelujah. Come on, saint. Give me some volume on this microphone. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Yeah. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If you begin to praise God, you can be healed right there at your seat. Hey, 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 hey. Watch the church. A blockage of the heart's going to go right now. I decree it in Jesus' name by the authority of God, Brother Steve, right now. Heart trouble, you're gone. Blockage of the heart, you're open. She's free in Jesus' name. Go ahead and jump all you want to. Jump all you please. What's the matter? Heart trouble, lift your hands. It's going to go. Lamb of God, right now. Right now. Right now. Heart trouble, we speak to you in the name of Jesus. You heal me of heart trouble, and devil, you can't do nothing about it. God's hands upon this woman, she's healed now. Begin to jump and shout. Come on. Come on. Go ahead. Hallelujah. Heart, lift your hand. Heart trouble. God, you've got a heart clinic going. You've got a heart clinic going. Dear God, you are master. You are master of the heart. Now let the muscles open up. Let the blood flow. Dear God, he has no heart disease because you're a healer in Jesus' name. Thank God. Go ahead. Exercise.
The man that had a heart attack, and the doctor said he didn't have 20% of his heart left. He's running somewhere around this building. I said, he's running somewhere around this building. He said, God, just heal me. God, just heal me. God, just heal me. Thank God. Come on back up here, brother. Run back up here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The miracle working God is in this room. I wish you'd throw up your hands and praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Glory. Go ahead and shout, mother. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. It's yours. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And you the one? You the one? How you breathing?
Like you would be if you just ran back. But I'll tell you one thing. I couldn't have walked all the way back there as fast.
You couldn't walk back there. And you ran back up here.
Ran back up, yes.
I want you to shout, Lord, I'm healed.
Lord, I'm healed.
Hallelujah. 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 Go praising God. Don't let the devil tell you anything but victory. Victory in Jesus.
When I came down here, it felt like that elephant up on the drum with Boothie. Yesterday I had... Well, this morning I got up, and it felt like he must have not ate last night, that elephant, because he sure wasn't as heavy. This afternoon when I come in, I know he was down to only 1 foot. Tonight, he's over there eating his hay.
Hey, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Here's a man has cancer on top of his head, fixing to be healed. I want you to lift your hand and say, God.
God,
you're a miracle worker.
You're a miracle worker.
I need a miracle.
I need a miracle.
I am. What you say.
What you say.
I am.
I am healed.
Healed.
I am healed.
I am healed.
I am healed.
I am healed. Begin to praise him for it now. Come on, thank him for it now. Go ahead. Go ahead. Praise him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. No more. It's gone. It's gone. Dear God, I thank you for divine deliverance, you demon of hell. You can't do nothing because the host is here. And yeah, go ahead. Go. It's all over you. Go ahead. It's all over you. Yes, Lord.
I'm a
Father, we command every joint in this body, every pain's going to leave, not tomorrow, but right now. You demon of hell, we come against you. We declare clear victory in the joints of this body in Jesus' name. I want you to bend your legs. I want you to find some pain. I want you to just try to find some pain in your body. Find the pain in your body. Find it. It is? Keep putting it back there. Put your hand back there again. Yeah. What you know? Yeah. Yeah. Thank God. Now then. Yeah. Walk in His name. Go ahead. Bend them legs. Why don't you just run down that aisle? Run. Run over anybody gets in front of you. Just run over them. Thank God. Heavenly Father, he's had a heart attack, and this arm's in pain constantly. Was in pain. It's now.
Was in pain. It's and going to be gone tonight is my night for this miracle.
Well, what do you know? You got it in the hand. The blood's flowing. The blood's flowing through that arm. The blood's flowing.
In Jesus'
name. It's done. In Jesus' name. Yeah. Try to find any pain. That's gone. Ears open up. Open these deaf ears. Devil, you're the demon of deafness. But we come against you in Jesus' name. By the authority of God's word, we stand here agreeing in the word. Here's more than two of us agreeing. Here's more than five of us agreeing. Dear God, here's more than seven agreeing. This whole church agrees right now. Let these ears come to a place of opening up and let her hear in Jesus' name. Jesus. No, say it loud. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. Say Jesus. You are my healer. Say Jesus. You are my healer. Jesus. You are my healer. Lift your hands and praise Him, part daughter. That's right. Don't be ashamed. Just praise Him. Thank God. That's right. She's got to learn to talk.
And I have a heart murmur.
You have a heart murmur? No more. No more. It's gone. Go ahead and praise Him for it. It's gone. Thank God it's gone. It's gone. Yeah. Thank God. Thank God. Thank God. Lamb of God. We come in your name. We come in your name, Jesus. Jesus, you said the lame shall walk. The deaf shall hear. The deaf shall know. Dear God, I ask the hand of God to come upon now. We join, dear God, with our faith in you. Dear God, knowing there's nothing impossible. Nothing impossible. Let these legs come alive. Let muscles come alive. Jesus, in thy name, in thy name, in thy name. Thank God. Thank God. Come on. Let's walk for Jesus. Let's walk for Jesus. Let's walk for Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Why don't somebody praise Him? Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Walk, walk in Jesus' name. Walk, walk, walk in Jesus' name. Walk, walk, walk in Jesus' name. Devil, you are a thief and a liar. You've come to steal. God is coming. You might have life. 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 Thank God. If I can just get you to praise God. Miracles are God-given. Miracles are divine intervention of God into the human affairs of mankind. Come on, give him the praise for it. Thank you, I don't care what you have need of tonight. If there's a need in your life and you want God to give you a miracle tonight, get in this line and begin to walk in down here. Don't wait till the last one's prayed. We're going to change the order of the service, and then there will be no more praying. Either get in right now or forget it. Heavenly Father, every person we lay hands on, whether there's two or three that agree, we agree together, dear God, and we come in your name. Heavenly Father, we lay
hands on.
Won't be no more. Thank God. You've been coming to this church a long time, I know. And thank God you're a miracle walking and you're a miracle talking. Go ahead and praise him.
By his stripes I am healed. By his stripes I am healed. And the devil is alive.
Yeah. Amen. 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 Amen.
More of us. He pays.
You got it. You got it. You got it. You got it. Thank God. Thank God. Pray and praise him. Heavenly Father, we're just going to lay hands like you said, and you're going to do the work. You're going to do the healing. Every person we touch tonight. Every person. Now. Now. Amen. Just keep on coming. Come on, lay your hands, brethren. Jesus, in thy name. Everyone in Jesus' name. Go ahead. Go ahead. Go ahead and praise him. Thank the Lord. Thank the Lord. Thank you. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready for a miracle? It's yours. It's yours. You don't have to ask for it. You've come believing for it. It's yours now. Go ahead and just keep praising. Praise him. It's done. Walk in his name. Walk in his name. Thank God. Thank God. Hallelujah. Lord, I told him, son, I can't tell you to take your bandage off. I'm not a doctor. But I can tell you this, you're healed and you can do what you want to. Move your hand. What do you know? You're not supposed to move that hand. Wiggle your hand around real good. Wiggle your thumb. Take your hand out. Raise it up. Raise up your hand. Wiggle your fingers. I thought it was broke. I thought it was huh? Your wrist is broke? What are you moving your hands for then? Huh? Come on, praise God, saints. Thank God. Come on, keep moving them. It's all right. It's all right. Keep moving. Thank God. Ha-ho! Yes, Lord. Come on. Go ahead. You ready? Go ahead and shout. The victory's already yours. Lamb of God, it's hers in Jesus' name. Come on. Dear God, you've already given a miracle on that face. I thank you for it in Jesus' name. Dear God, we lay hands upon them. We decree a miracle in Jesus' name.
Are you ready?
The mind to this daughter. Yep. Holy Ghost, glory be to God in Jesus' name. Are you really ready? All right, begin to praise him. Sata kapayila mahanda bakata. Yes, 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 yes. Go ahead, go ahead. My God, my God, my God, my God. Matoso kupriya malahata in the power. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Ha, are you really ready? Are you ready? No, you're not. You're not ready. You're not ready. Now, come on, begin to praise him. Yield to that Spirit of God in Jesus' name. By the power of the Holy Ghost, go praising him. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. My pastor, the key. By the power of Almighty God, by the power of Almighty God. Yeah, 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 yeah. Nah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Devil's a liar. Devil's a liar. The devil's a liar. Jesus said, you're healed. You're healed. By the power and spirit of Almighty God, go praise in him. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank Sokra Bakila Bahandaba. Now the power, the power. Glory, 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 glory. Right now, Lord, when I touch this woman, the Spirit of God will go through her. The power of the Holy Ghost. Yield to the Spirit, honey. Let God do it, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Father, it's all right. 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 Sakapataha. Handarabakoya. Yes, sir, it's all right. Go ahead, go ahead, go ahead. Go ahead, go ahead. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Long enough you've tormented her, Satan. Long enough. Curse this growth. I bind it to go and command it to go in the name of Jesus. Oh God, oh God, yes Lord, it's going down right now. It's going down. It's going down. It's going down. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. God, my God, we lay hands upon this man and the Spirit of Almighty God go through the crown of his head to the sole of be it done, Lord, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. Father, in Jesus' name, we come against the powers of fear and doubt and worry. But you said in your word, whatsoever I ask in your name, I ask you to take the pain, the suffering, out of this body in Jesus' name. Oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Be it done, Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I receive it in Jesus' name. I receive it. It's your word. I claim it. I confess it in Jesus' name. Deliverance now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I wish somebody would praise God. I wish somebody would praise him. Praise him. Praise him. Oh, hallelujah. Parabakata satarabakata. Yito ko rabakata. Yatasa. Kirabakakata. Give him praise. Give him praise. Give him praise. Your word works, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Horabakakata. Rabakata. In Jesus' name, receive it, receive it, receive it. Oh, hallelujah. Give him praise, give him praise. Don't just look, come on, give God praise. Praise him for somebody else's victory. Foul, tormenting spirit. Go! Go! Tara, it's done in Jesus' name. It's done in Jesus' name. The word of God flow through.
Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Right now, Lord. Right now, Lord. Every worry. Every tormenting spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I speak the word of God that's like fire flowing through her body. Hallelujah. I give you glory. I give you glory. I thank you for victory. I thank you for victory. I thank you for victory. Your word, dear God, flow through this body. Hallelujah. It's your power. It's your anointing. It's your anointing, Lord. It's your anointing. It's your anointing, Lord. I thank you. The anointing destroys the yoke. That's it. I receive it, Lord. Right now. That's it. Give him the praise. Give him the praise. Just say, here I am, Lord. Turn it on. Turn it on, Lord. Day forth it shall be. Thank God. Give him the praise for it. My God, your word is truth. I thank you. It's done in Jesus' name. That's it. Give him the glory. Give him the glory. Give him the glory. Give God the glory right now. It's your word. I receive it. There's nothing too hard for you. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Lord, in Jesus' name, the cry of the heart, satisfy tonight. Satisfy tonight. Oh, hallelujah. Yes.
Exactly what you want right now. We're going to pray and it's going to happen. Father, in the name of Jesus, I bind the powers of fear and doubt and worry, and this your servant, he's a miracle.
Thank you, Lord. I receive it now. That's it. Praise him. Praise him. Lord, there's nothing. Nothing too hard. My God, I give you glory for victory. I wish somebody would shout. I wish somebody would shout hallelujah. I wish somebody would shout hallelujah. Receive it in Jesus' name. It's yours. Hallelujah. Lord, I thank you. I thank you for victory. I receive victory. I receive victory. Let him do it. Let him do it. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. It's my night. It's my time. You're the miracle worker. Thank you. Thank you.
Brother Maurice, somebody right here. Right along in here in this line, you've been suffering in your body. You don't know what's wrong with you, but God told me to stop this prayer line and tell you that you're healed right now. If you'll just raise your hand and praise God, you can get out of your line and come down here and confess it, because God said the pain is gone, the sickness is gone, the worry is gone. Come on, praise God. They're coming. Here they come. Come on. I know what God said. God said, I have set you free. I have set you free. Thank God you've suffered long enough and the devil's had you bound. Do you believe what I say? Lift your hands and praise God.
God by the power of the husband. Rub your hands on her legs. In the name of Jesus, I bind this devil. I give her victory. Now, which leg gave you the most trouble? All right, I want you to kick the devil with that leg. Come on, kick him. Kick him hard. No, I want you to kick him like he can't get up now. That's it, that's it, that's it, that's it, that's it. There you are, there you are. My God, my. Now begin to jump up and down on those legs and praise God. Jump up and down. Come on, come on, get off your feet. Praise him, praise him, praise him. That's it, that's it. My God, you don't have to have us to touch you. All you got to do is to believe. Throw up your hands and praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You can't hold her now, husband. Thank God she's gone. The victory's there. Praise God. Woo! Go ahead. How long has it been that you couldn't do that?
Six months.
I want you to kick that devil again. Kick him hard. Kick him hard. Kick him harder. Devil, you'll not come back into my body. I loose you and bind you in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Now begin to walk in Jesus' name. Every step you take is going to get stronger. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him. Come on, praise him.
All you got to do is just praise him. That's all you got to do. Thank God. Turn this microphone up, somebody. Thank you, Lord. Yes, Lord. No more. Is it the pain?
The pain is gone.
The pain?
Yes.
You had pain, Lord?
Yes, I did. The whole time I was here, the pain running down this arm is gone.
Ooh. Hey, 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 hey. Praise God. Go ahead. Go ahead. Thank God. You've been suffering a long time, but it's over with. It's over with now. I decree it by the authority of God. For devil, you are alive. Victory is hers in the name of Jesus of Nazareth. I come against every evil force of hell. Loose and set her free. You are free. You are free. You are free in the name of Jesus. Thank God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on, honey. Thank God.
Oh, Lord, I thank you. I give you glory for victory now. Somebody say victory now. Somebody say victory now. Victory now. Right now. Right now. You know the problem? I receive the answer, Lord. I receive the answer. In Jesus' name. Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Wow. Oh, I think somebody ought to praise God. That are not in the line, just throw up your hands and say, God, I feel you in this place right now. I feel you in this place right now. Glory to God. Come on and praise him, brother. Praise him, brother. My God, praise him. You can begin to praise God, and the victory is yours. Devil, we bind you on the authority of the word of God. Satan, loose your hold. Loose your hold. Loose your hold. Loose your hold. My God, come on, somebody, somebody give him some praise. Somebody give him some glory. Thank God I give you victory in the name of Jesus. I bind every affliction, every sickness, every pain that's in these bodies in Jesus' name. Come on, somebody shout hallelujah. Somebody shout hallelujah. Some of you folks have been in this line two or three times already. Come on and give God some praise. Give God some praise. Give God some praise. I bind the enemy. I loose your heel.
Jesus, in my name. You see every voice written down there. I decree the miracle in Jesus' name. Thank God. Thank God.
Yes, Lord. Jesus. Heavenly Father, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Dear God, it doesn't matter what the devil's trying to do. He stopped in his tracks. He stopped in his tracks. By the word of God, we send deliverance in your name.
Brother Ralph, there's somebody in this room. You have been to the doctor this week, and the doctor gives you a bad report. If you'll come down here, I guarantee you God will give you a good report. You went to the doctor this week. I want that person that went to the doctor this week and God spoke to me that you were in here and he wanted to heal you. He wanted to show you that he's mindful of you. You're in this room right now. And if you'll come down here, I guarantee you'll go home a free person. Come on, lift your hands, everybody, and shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Maybe you already got your miracle and just want to confirm it. But bless God, when you begin to praise God, the devil's got to get out of your path, get out of your house, get out of your life, and get away from you. The joy of the Lord becomes your strength, and glory will come unto you. Come on, come on, somebody say praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Devil, I bind you in the name. And the fullness of power and victory be yours in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. He was wounded for your transgression. He was bruised for your iniquities. And surely Jesus bore all your sorrows, and with his stripes you are healed. Come on. Oh, he was wounded for my transgression. He was bruised for my iniquities. And surely Jesus bore all my sorrows, and with his stripes I am healed. I want everyone that wants to have a visitation from God. You want to have a visitation from God, not next month, but before this week passes. You want the Lord. You know, when he walked into my room and he told me, when I was laying on the bed, I'd had an accident in Detroit, broke my knee, and I could not walk. And the Lord Jesus came into my room and said, "Son, I'll heal you Sunday." I said, "But God, I'm suffering right now." He said, "I'll heal you Sunday." I had my workers to bring me down out of my office, and I had a cast on my leg. And I want you to know, when all of a sudden one of my elders was praying, and he said, "My God, I feel God here. My back, I've had trouble for 22 years, but I feel that there's no pain." And I said, "This is my time. Step me up." They put me up behind the pulpit, took the cast off of my leg, and I put my foot, and the doctor said, "If you ever put your weight on that foot, you'll ruin the cartilage in your knee and you'll be crippled the rest of your life." And the devil was laughing at me and standing in front of me telling me that. But I began to put my weight on that leg, and all of a sudden I put all of my strength on it. I jumped up, down, run down the steps and up the steps, and the Spirit of God began to move, and a woman sitting in the third row jumped up and said, "I come to be healed." And the power of God, I didn't have to pray for her. She said, "I haven't walked in 12 years. She come running out of that aisle and around the building and glorifying God. I'm here to tell you, God said he wants to give you a miracle. He wants to give you joy. If you want God, you want God to give you a visitation right now, just walk by and touch our hand and begin to praise God. Come on, begin to praise God. I give you that miracle. I give you that miracle of the visitation, of the visitation. I give it to you, Lord. It'll happen in your life. It'll happen before Monday, because you're going to wake them up. Come on, somebody praise God in the name of Jesus. A visitation by the power and Spirit of God.
visitation. God, I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. My God, I didn't know there's so many that wanted a visitation. Begin to praise God. Don't just stand there. Praise God. Begin to rejoice. Begin to rejoice. Begin to rejoice. God, in Jesus' name, I give you the miracle that you've longed for, and the powers of the enemy be destroyed, and fear will go, and doubt will go, and be healed in the name of Jesus. Bless them by the power, and give them this visitation by the anointing of God. Oh, hallelujah. My God, I wish somebody would just start shouting. Somebody start speaking in tongues. When you speak in tongues, the devil don't know what you're saying. But that Holy Ghost is real. By the power of Almighty God. Hallelujah. 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 My God. My God. My God. My God. Wait a minute, right where you are. There's somebody that hadn't come by yet. And God is speaking to you right now. And the devil's telling you it's not going to happen. But I want you to raise your hand and you'll have that visitation tonight. In the name of Jesus, I praise you for it. I praise you for it. I give you the power. I give you the visitation. The anointing of God. Bless this man. Bless this child, this woman. By the power of the Holy Ghost. The visitation of God. The visitation of God. I want you to begin to jump up and down and say, it's mine, it's mine, it's mine, it's mine. Come on, come on and praise him. It's mine, it's mine. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I feel Jesus in this place. I wish somebody had shout glory. Somebody shout glory. Ma papa ta kala bahandaraba. Holy andaraba sata. Yiko pasata.
This is
the beginning of a new area for you. You're going to walk in the Spirit of God. You're going to have the power of God to come upon you. Your tears will flow. Your hands will be anointed. And your life will be changed from this moment forth, saith God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh God.
In this place.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You look so much different right now.
Oh, my soul.
Listen.
Wait a minute. This man's a pastor, and the doctor said he shouldn't come here, and he wasn't able to travel, but God has healed him. And he said, my wife and I are both pastors, and we're going to go back to our church and have a miracle service.
In this place.
It's worth praising. It's worth having a visitation.
I feel healing.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, I feel healing. Oh, Lord. I feel healing.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
This place.
We thank for the outpouring of the Holy Ghost.
God,
we give you the praise, Lord.
Oh, yes, it does.
Jesus, in thy name.
I feel Jesus.
You haven't praised God enough.
Oh,
lift
Lord
holy it. Hands to him.
I feel Jesus in this.
Glory.
In this place.
Thank God. For I know.
Oh, my soul.
Lord, we thank you. Lord, we thank you.
In me, oh Lord, I feel
Jesus.
A visitation, Lord.
Oh,
a visitation.
This
place. Thank God.
I feel Jesus.
A visitation. Lord, a visitation.
I feel Jesus. I feel Jesus.
Lord, a visitation from heaven. From every individual. Jesus, in thy name.
In this place. Oh, Lord. Oh, my soul,
a visitation.
Burns within me. Oh, thank you, Lord. I feel Jesus.
I want everyone to stretch your hands towards the women that's made all this food for this whole gang every night, every day. Here they are. I'm going to ask my brothers to come. We're going to lay hands upon every one of them, asking God to touch them for their ministry. Your ministry has helped thousands of people, but you don't know every bite of food that you've served has gone to the glory of God. Amen.
It's a ministry of hospitality. He said, if when you give a servant a cold glass of water in his name, you've done much more than water. It's not in vain, women. It's not in vain, girls. When you feed these men, God's going to feed your house. Stretch your hands towards him.
Yes, Lord. Brothers, come on. Lord, in thy name. In thy name. Lord, touch sister in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Lord, we're going to anoint every one of these. We're going to anoint right with the oil. It's very vital what y'all are doing. It's a ministry that no one appreciates. It's a ministry that no one wants to do. But we, then, Lord, we anoint them in your name. We anoint them in your name. Lord, these are your servants. They have a ministry, dear God. Every night they're doing the job. Lord, we anoint them. We anoint them. We anoint them, dear God. Father, we anoint them. Every one of them, we anoint, dear God. Lord, we anoint.
Oh,
do something special for them. Do something special.
Burn within me.
All right, brothers, come on. Let's pray right here. Join hands with all the ministers. Let's join hands, sisters. We're praying for you right now. Heavenly Father, I ask you to put a special anointing, a special blessing upon every one of these men, upon these women that's labored every night, dear God. They don't get no pay earthly for it, but they're going to get pay in heaven like they never dreamed of. The ministry of hospitality, how they made us feel wonderful, how they made us feel at home. Dear God, let thy mighty hand be upon them. Let thy hand reach out to them and touch their own house. Provide. Provide, provide, provide in Jesus' name for them. They provide for us now. You provide for them. In thy name, we thank you and praise you for it. Amen. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Lord, we thank you. 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 I am the Lord thy God. Do you not know that my eyes are upon the righteous and my ears open unto your cry? You have served time and time and time again. But behold, it hadn't gone unnoticed. Remember, your deeds are recorded. I want you to know the reward shall be yours because you've helped these that are living. And now I'll help you while you live. I'll give you peace. I'll give you prosperity. My hand shall be upon you, saith the Lord. Hallelujah.
In this place.
Listen, I must do what the Lord spoke to my heart. I must do it. Can I have your attention? Can anybody here feel the responsibility of building
a building like God has laid upon your pastor? Do you feel a little responsibility? How many knows that'll be a landmark for God? When I'm gone, I don't know how much longer I'll be able to come. I don't know how much longer I'll live, to tell you the truth. But I know this, that I've got a God that he said, you'll be rewarded accordingly to the deeds done in the body. You'll be rewarded for it. Brother Steve said, Brother Hart, I said, can I do? He said, well, no, don't raise it. I said, then he said, well, go ahead, whatever God speaks to you. He didn't want me to do it. But I know this. God's got people here tonight that wants to do something, and every dime of it will go to the building fund. Every dime of it. Every time they back that concrete truck over there, $750. About 20 loads have already gone in the ground. Think about 100 times 750. That's 700. That's $250,000 real quick. $750,000 real quick. That's already gone in there. Think how much more has got to be done. You can't stop. When the prophet started building, he didn't stop. You can't stop. You got to keep going. Those that makes a vow to God, Brother Steve, just get me some envelopes. I want no mark on them. Don't want no name on them. I just want to get me some envelopes, and this is building fund. If God speaks to your heart to do any amount, I don't care what it is, there's no amount that won't be appreciated.